Anyways, guys, what's good, everyone? What is good? Welcome back to the channel with yours truly, of course, Machiavelli. Hope you guys are having a great Saturday, and today we are back with another speed build. And today's speed build, we are doing another Scandinavian apartment. I don't know why, I just like this apartment. I've seen it on Pinterest, so I thought I'd go ahead and make it. And I kind of got carried away building one room. It took me like 30 minutes to build one room because, like I said, I got carried away and I was thinking about other things. Yeah, but anyways, moving on. But today's commentary is gonna be about childhood. Our childhood in that sense. It's like a get to know me better type of situation. I feel like I always talk about my childhood, talking about how much I loved, you know, anime and cartoons, but we're gonna talk about like memories and stuff like that. But anyways, so how this even came about is, I told you guys many times, is one of my greatest fears is nothingness. like having time on my hands to like think. I hate thinking does nothing for me. Well, depend on what type of thinking. If it's like, you know, like thinking, that's fine. But if it's like blank thinking, like last night I was going to sleep and I couldn't go to sleep, and so my mind was just running, and like it just started bringing up all these memories that I didn't want to think about. Put me in a very, I don't say uncomfortable, very weird state last night. And so I just been feeling so icky and just remembering all my childhood memories. And I hate, okay, fun fact, I'm pretty sure everyone went through this. Everyone always wanted to grow up when they were kids, you know. We're like, oh my god, I can't wait to be an adult and then have, you know, be able to drink and drive. Well, not drink and drive together, but you know what I mean, like be able to drive and drink, not together though. you know, do all these adult stuff. But now you're an adult, you're like, god damn, I miss nap time, I miss not caring about stuff to do, I miss just going to school and just like hanging out with my friends and not worrying too much about my future. And now you're older and all this type of stuff that happened. And then I started like thinking more deep into that and like all my childhood stuff. And then I realized, you know, all my mistakes growing up. And I just literally sat in my bed thinking for about 30-40 minutes. Like through that thinking, I cried a little bit because thinking about my memories, I had some really dark memories of my childhood. And then I started laughing because all the stupid stuff I did. It just put me in this damper after, you know. And that's why I hate thinking. I hate letting my mind wander. It's never always a good wander that makes me, you know, happy and giddy. But no, I always think about the bad things. I hate my mind sometimes. But yeah, and I don't know, I thought it would be cool to share some of your, like, childhood memories, or the ones that really stuck out to you a lot. I don't know. My household has been crazy since, like, 2019 has been that kind of year. My household has been all types of messed up / crazy. Things have changed, people have left, it's crazy right now. And so, I don't know, just remembering how, I don't say how good life was, or how, like, peaceful, and how I thought, quote unquote, thought I had a perfect, amazing family growing up. It was like a bursting bubble. Like, wow, Malik, you are so stupid to think that way. But anyways, we're not gonna talk about all the depressing stuff. Today we're gonna talk about the happy memories. So down below, comment, what was your favorite childhood memory? Like, one of your favorite childhood, you can tell me multiples if you want to, but what was that childhood memory that whenever you look back on, you have to smile and like, wow, those are some good times. I have a few, I actually do. I'm gonna talk to you guys about my childhood memories today. So one of my favorite ones was when we first moved here. We moved to where I live now. First of all, we used to live in a rat and roach infested house, so praise the Lord we moved here. And my mom is a superhero. She did it all by herself. Rep to my mom. I'm so proud of her. But anyways, moving on. But anyways, yeah, so we moved here and I didn't know anybody outside. And so I didn't know anyone to play with. I was in only grade 3 at that time. God damn, that was like, I was in grade 3, I was 8. That was over like 12 years ago. Oh my god. 12, 13 years ago. But anyways, yeah, so I was outside playing. No, I was outside playing. I want to play with people outside. But again, people just moved in. There was literally, talking about like, this division was just made. When I say it was just made, I mean there was dirt everywhere. No one had no grass in yet. No one had a fence up. No one had anything. Only thing that was built, not even the driveways were made. Only thing that was built was the house, and people moved in. Because me and my mom wanted to move in as quick as we can. Because one, I needed to grad. I need to like change schools. And two, I needed to we need to get that other place because it was terrible. Okay, sorry about that. I have no clue where I left off. My mic clunked out on me. Great times. But anyway, so back to the story. Let me just make it rounded up really short for you guys so I can tell you guys another story. I was outside playing this mud. The girl from the house in front of the mud place where I was playing, like, was looking at me. Then she came out and then she started playing with me and it was so much fun. We started laughing and I got to know her. Her name was Marina at the time. And we started playing and then her sister came out. And then all three of us was playing and it was like the best time. We're just sitting around playing in mud. And then I guess the kids from like around the street saw us play with the muds outside. So they like decided to come outside and then like a few other people came out. One of my good friends named Deontay, he came out and then his brother came out and then a guy named Nick came out. It was just, I guess that's how we made the trio. We were one, two. It was me, my brother, you. It was the seven of us. We were like the seven amigos. We did pretty much everything together. It was such a simple time. It's so weird. Like everyone, like we did everything together. We were always like, yo, we're coming outside. It was just, wow, the memories. Like, we literally did everything together. We hung out together every single day. Like, we came from school, we went to each other's houses. Like, we were the seven amigos. It was crazy. And then we grew up, and people started hating each other, and people got awkward, and we stopped talking to each other, and now we don't talk to each other anymore. Which is really sad, because we had such a great childhood. But, yeah, there was that memory. I always remember that memory of how much we hung out together. That friendship lasted, like, 3 to 5 years, somewhere around there, until it started falling apart. But anyways, moving on. That was one of my favorite memories, just making that group. I don't know. It was like from one of those movies where like all these people come together and then they just become friends. It was one of those. But anyways, moving on. Another one of my favorite childhood memories is back then too. Is like once everything started to develop and people, like, you know, some people got their backyards. There was no fences up in the backyard, so everyone could like walk. So you literally walk over your backyard to another person's backyard because there was like no fences and everything. And I guess everyone in the neighborhood one time decided to do manhunt. I have no clue if kids even know what manhunt is to this day. But manhunt is like a really big game of tag. But instead of how tag goes, it's like tag is you touch them and then they're it. It's manhunt is like you hunt them down, and so once you get tagged, you're officially it with the person, and so you guys work together to catch everybody else, and it keeps on going until there's only one person left to be tagged. And so it was like neighborhood, we called it neighborhood manhunt. We literally had like, it was the best thing ever. So we'd be inside like eating or watching TV. Someone would knock on our door and be like, yo, neighborhood manhunt in like 10 minutes. We're like, oh my God, yo, bro, neighborhood manhunt in 10 minutes. Like, really? So we like ran upstairs, got our clothes on, went to the meeting spot, 10 minutes, and then the game would start. It was so amazing. People would be like, yo, neighborhood manhunt. And we're like, okay. People got ready. People came with strategies. Like, this game was serious. It was the game of the neighborhood. People literally from other neighborhoods came over to play with us because it was our thing. Manhunt was serious. Like, you don't play. Like, it was a serious thing. Like, you would actually hear people scream. Like, you would like be hiding, and then you'd be like, someone like, no, and you're like, no, he's it, no, a fallen soldier. Oh my God, the memories. Manhunt was lit. But yeah, that was one of my, I think that's the greatest childhood memory I have, because I've never had so much fun in my life. That was the best. That was literally the best, and I miss it. Ugh, I miss it so much. That was such a great moment. Neighborhood manhunt. That was great. So there was that one. What do I also have? Ooh, another good memory was when I had my first girlfriend. Yes, I'm pretty sure I told you guys this already. My first girlfriend, her name's Priscilla. No clue where she is today. I met her like way, way back when I was in kindergarten. But yeah, she was my first girlfriend. We did everything together. Like, I don't remember fully, but I remember some stuff. But we did everything together. I remember one time we were at daycare, and I was talking to another girl, and she just, like, popped up beside me and had, like, this really screw-up face on. I think that was my greatest memory with her, because I was like, oh, you're jealous. I don't know, but anyways, yeah, there was that. Oh, jeez, Priscilla. Even my mom said she was my first love, because I took her everywhere. I took her home with me. No, but, like, she'd come over to play at my house, I'd go over to play at her house. She was at my birthday parties, all my birthday parties when I was there. We did everything together. Like, most of the pictures I have with her is we were holding hands. Good times with Priscilla. I still remember, I got my first kiss by her too. I don't know if it counts as a kiss because, you know, it was grade one. But anyways, so it was my birthday party at my house. Everyone was having fun and she's like, oh, I have a birthday gift for you. I'm like, okay, cool, it's my birthday gift. She's like, come with me. So I came with her. She locked me. I don't know why a great one's doing this, but she locked me in the bathroom and she gave me a kiss. I was like, I was shook. I was like, huh? Huh? She was like, happy birthday. And then she ran out the room. I'm like, what? I was so shook. I had my first kiss on my first birthday. It was a great time. Oh, it was a great time to be alive. Oh, Priscilla. I wonder what she's doing right now. I honestly wonder, what is she doing out there in the world? Maybe she's like a doctor. Hopefully she's alive still. I'd be really sad if she wasn't. Oh yeah, damn. I actually do wonder what's going on with her. I don't think I go on Facebook and find her, but I just don't know her last name. My mom doesn't know her last name, so I really can't even try to find her either. But I really wonder what she's like. Anyways, what is next in my childhood memories that I loved? Oh, there's also one. Going across the border. When I say go across the border, I mean going to the United States. When I was growing up, I glorified America. I love Canada. And now that I'm older, I really appreciate Canada, but I glorified the heck out of America. I thought America was the best thing ever. I thought no one could come near America. I thought America was the king of all countries and that everybody who lives there was royal. Not really, but like, I just thought America was the ish. And so I always asked my mom, oh, can I go to America? Can I go to America? And we'd like never go because we couldn't afford it. And we like, it depends on what the sense is. Like, we could afford it. We'd go to Pennsylvania for like a day, then we'd come back. But like, we never truly went to like America because we just went across the border for like a day, you know, if that makes any sense. But you know, I really wanted to go to New York. I've always loved New York. New York has always been my favorite. I think it's called state there. State. Yeah, it's my favorite state in America. It still is. That and... yeah, I think it's just New York. I don't know. I don't really like anywhere else. But yeah, so New York has always been that number one place. And so I finally got to know New York, which is actually, there's not even a childhood memory. I went to New York for the first time when I was in grade 9, but that will forever be one of the best moments because I got to experience it. You know, like it's like when a dream comes true. It's like when I went to Japan, but again, Japan was when I was 18. That ain't a childhood memory. I guess it's a memory now because that was like 5 years ago. But anyways... yeah, I was just so excited and I loved it. And I actually found my grandfather for the first time because he lives in, what's it called again? New York. Yeah, I figured out, like, my mom always told me about my grandfather, like, ripped to him because he kind of abandoned her when she was a young age. Yeah, that happened. And my grandmother had to raise my mom on her own. And so she never really knew her dad that much, but then she found him when we went to New York. That's actually the main reason why we went to New York, so like they could meet each other. It was very awkward. And y'all want to hear the tea about my grandfather? Like, Jesus, that man is something else. So my grandmother, well, my step grandmother in that sense, is younger than my mom. Yeah, my grandpa is 73, yeah, and my mom is 52, and my grandmother, well, my step-grandmother is 50. Yeah, that happened. Wait, no, my bad, my grandpa is 80-something, I think, and he's not 73, I think he's 83, not 73, yeah, he's 83. There's a 30-something year difference. When he was 30, his wife was born. Just think about that. When he was 34, his wife was born. Yeah, that man was an old-ass man when his wife was born. Like, really? Like, it's so weird. Like I don't know what my mom to do. Like, did my mom, like... how do you do this when your stepmother is younger than you? Like, how do you feel about that? Like, you were already 4 years old when you're... No, you're... She was two when her stepmother was born. I can't even. Anyways, but yeah, that type of G my grandpa is. But anyways, that's the T. But anyways, I think I'm gonna go ahead and end off this commentary here. I hope you guys did enjoy. And of course, leave your childhood memories down below. I'd love to hear them. And I'll see you guys in the next one. I'm out. Have a great Saturday, and I'll see y'all on Sunday. Bye, guys. Oh no, I think I've lost my mind.